Boswell. It's good to be here in this part of the house. My own living room, as my mom made me move to the other side of the kitchen table. But oh, this living room, I got more space. Today we're going to be talking about America's Good Time Game Scrabble. We're going back in time, so pay close attention. Alfred Butts, and in the 1930s, he invented a new type of board game called Lexica, which evolved into Criss Crosswords, a precursor to Scrabble. In 1948, James Brunot, a resident of Newton, Connecticut, and other owners of the original Criss Crosswords game, bought the rights to manufacture the game for gaining bets of royalty on every unit sold and decided on a new name, Scrabble. Man, this game has come such a long way. In variations like a deluxe edition, one that has its spinning board and grid to keep the letters in place, even a travel editions, and even a game show! That's right, a game show hosted by Chuck Rory. You know what I'm talking about. The original letter distribution from the original is still in use today. Now let's take a look at a couple of Scrabble games which I happen to own. First type here is a bookshelf game, Scrabble. I gotta get this open first. Here we go. There's the original history of it inside. There's the game board. Let's shut here just as soon as I open it. There we go. There's another real one. And there's the light racks, along with the tiles in a cloth bag. There's the instructions. The second type I have is the travel version in a game folio. That would just cut up here. There it is. Everywhere's a letter. It keeps your tiles locked in place, so you can pick it up later. There's the inside, there's the rack. And now there's the game board. Neat, huh? It folds easily. Well, that's all for today.